I meet the order, please. If I could, I'd ask everyone to stand with the pledge of allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you very much and welcome to the June regular city council meeting. I'd like to ask everyone if they would to silence their phone or turn it off or cell phone, if you would, please. The item two is consideration of adoption of the agenda. Any corrections to the agenda? I think we do have some corrections. I think under item A, number two, recommended by council will be postponed until July meeting, correct, council?
Yes, sir. We don't have all the documentation prepared on that. It's not there. We respect the request of motion authorizing postponing new business item A2 to July meeting.
Okay. Chair entertain motion to postpone that to July. Yeah, I think you did decide to, administration A2. Have a motion and second in discussion. All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Any opposed? Unanimous. Thank you very much. Okay, also, I would recommend postponement item three under section A, the new business. This is in relation to Mason Street, which is the proposed area that the county to build the parking deck. And all the documentations and land acquisitions are not in order for that to go further at this time. So I recommend that to be postponed until the July meeting.
I'll take the vote.
Have a motion on the list. Do I have a second? Points in discussion. All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. And that's postponed to the July meeting. Okay. Any other items to be postponed?
Yes, sir, Mr. Mayor. I've spoken with the applicants, and they'd like to postpone item C2, our new business planning zoning, rezoning request number 2013149.
Under item C, number two.
Yes, sir. To postpone to the July meeting.
So the July meeting?
Yes, sir.
I make a motion to postpone.
I have a motion from Lewis. Do I have a second?
Second.
In discussion. All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Okay, I hear a motion to adopt agenda as amended.
Make a motion.
Do I have a second?
Second.
Second. In discussion. All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. All right, item three, executive session. Council, we have a need for an executive session?
No, sir, not tonight.
Thank you. Thank you. Item four, I assume everybody got a copy of the May 21st regular city council meeting with no correction. Chair, let me make a motion. Have a motion. Have a second.
Second.
In discussion. All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Item five, acknowledgements, proclamation, resolutions. Having none, we'll go to item six, old business. This was a traffic study that was authorized by the board back in, I think, February, morning after middle. And he had called early this week and informed the city council, city manager, that the study was in rough draft, and he would bring it tonight for council review. So Jason would engineering firm, so Jason, anything you want to add to what I just said?
Pretty much, Mayor, you said exactly what it is. It's a rough draft of the type of study.
This is mostly a rough drafting for the council's review.
Yes, sir.
And we can come back with some kind of proposal at maybe for next meeting. I'm sure that being in rough draft form, some of the people I know that live on Ridgecrest are here that might want to review it too. There's not an issue with them reviewing this, I would say. We have a topic for y'all, we'll give y'all that, Frank, to review it. Y'all were saying it at Ridgecrest, you kind of busted with that, so. With that presented, the chairman of Mason entertained a motion to postpone this, so I'm sure there's several recommendations from y'all in here to come up with the one that's most suitable for the area then. What's the pleasure of the board?
That's what I was saying.
A motion to postpone the traffic study to July meeting and come up with some kind of plan. Same time without taking consideration, there was no money in our budget when we were on the budget last year. We got to look and see if we got money in contingency to see what the cost would be. So that's one of the items that we got to take into consideration. So I got a motion and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, postpone to July, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. If any of y'all would like to have a copy of this, I've got one copy here. We make it, or y'all can make it.
Mr. Mayor, if I might, I'm just going to stop by City Hall and tomorrow pick up maybe four copies.
Yes, sir. We make that arrangement for them.
All right. And I'll just see Louise if that would be accepted.
Copy St. Gerald's stated.
All right. Thank you.
They'll know firsthand, so.
Great.
St. Gerald's stated.
All right. I'll stop by every lunch tomorrow. So. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jason.
Thank you.
Motion for second. Postpone this to July meeting.
That's for voting.
Item seven, administration, the EPD Consent Order, Council.
Mr. Mayor, members of the council, we have negotiated the proposed consent order with the EPD and the master plan trust related to the Lake Dallas Dam, which as y'all are aware, failed last month. And it is in your packet, the two-page agreement that in essence requires within 60 days of today Division EPD executes the order for us to come up with a plan and to approve that plan and for us to implement that plan of both stabilization and assessment of some positive remediation.
In other words, council approved the consent order for EPD's consideration tonight. We've got 60 days to draw up the plans of what?
Yeah, we got just be us.
Here.
Us and the master family for us, but the two respondents did it. And the EPD is aware that we were meeting tonight. I've had conversations with them and with the Corps of Engineers. And this will be the first step. I would ask at the conclusion of our discussion for a motion authorizing the mayor to execute this consent order. Assuming the master trust executed it and the EPD executed it, then it would be mine.
Well, that would be part of it, but Forsyth County would also be a part of this.
We have requested that Forsyth County, in fact, says it here that the city of Cumming contends that Forsyth County should be a respondent. Forsyth County has said that they do not believe that they should be named as a respondent. And they specifically requested that language, and the EPD director agreed. We're putting our contention in, which they should be a party. They're putting their contention in, which they don't think they should be a party.
The way the city became a part of it anyway was because the city accepted a donation from Semler Corporation of 12 acres land, or something like 12 acres of land.
Yes.
Which was wetland, that we hope to use at some time for a trade-off for other land. And due to the fact that the city was made ownership of this property, and due to the fact that the city had a 50-foot portion of Buford Dam Road.
Sanders Road.
I mean, Sanders.
Yes, that's correct.
I don't see that the county would be exempt from sharing the cost of whatever percentage, you know, it would be. So anyway, we'll work toward that in 60 days, provide the council agree.
Yes.
Okay, what's the pleasure of the board?
Request a motion, please, authorize the mayor to execute this consent order on behalf of the city.
Chair, entertain a motion. Motion from Johnny Depp, have a second.
Second.
Second from Lewis. In discussion. All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you, council.
Okay, item two has been postponed to July. Item three is postponed for July. Playhouse Department requesting for new light for the field. Amanda Hurd, Director of Arts, Academy of Arts, and County Georgia.
Yes, sir, this is a request for a new light for the county playhouse. We would pay the cost to be about $40,000, and we would like some grants, and we hope that we receive some other appropriate contributions to aid in that. This is a budget tonight, and I'm under capital emergencies for issues, and the urgency of it, we had some problems with the license, the cost of repair, and we might go ahead and start it. We the city's budget money, so we would finish that with grants and appropriate donations.
Well, I mean, you've done a great job, and I think you have a job to do, and it shows the amount of entertainment you have. As a matter of fact, I was just up earlier today, and I had compliments on this. It shows that they saw a few weeks ago, that, so that we're talking about the shows. And we had a treat to come eat at town. We never had eaten at town backstage, so we ate and went to the show. So we compliment you on the job you do. Obviously, the lighting is, what, 10-year-old now, and it's not actually put in for the type of shows that we're having anyway. I think it was put in for more or less to have reading classes up there or something like that.
Not that. Only it was over stability, being moved lights. It's worked. We may work, but after years, a lot of wear and tear.
And the cost is not to exceed what amount?
Not to exceed $40,000.
Okay. Council, have any questions? What's the pleasure of the board? Not to exceed $40,000 in the playhouse. We have a motion from Quinson, second from Lewis. In discussion. All in favor of the request, be signified by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you, Matt. Okay, we have planning zoning. Item one, annexation request for 2013-149. Our motion director. Director of planning zoning.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
I draw your attention to the staff report back. Automation Inc. has made application to annex 13.358 acres in the city limits and rezone it to restricted industrial. Scioto County has said they have no objection to the proposed annexation rezoning. That letter from the county attorney is in the packet. The property is currently vacant, and the owner is proposing a master plan complex expansion to their industrial corporate campus, which is directly across Hutchins Road. As a part of this annexation rezoning, the property owner is seeking a 10% parking variance, which would reduce the required number of parking spaces by 50 from 604 to 544, which would include 26 handicap spaces. The subject property is shown on the city's comprehensive plan as a potential area for the annex, and it is in conformance with the future land use plan. And the best of our knowledge, the annexation rezoning to have one of the restricted industrial will not
adversely affect the adjacent property owner's values or control of their properties. The planning board did hold a public hearing on May 21st, 2013, and with no recorded opposition, they recommended approval of the annexation and rezoning along with the parking variance with the following three conditions. Number one, the proposed office complex development will adhere to the city of Cumming zoning ordinance section 113-182, which is the table of dimensional requirements and unless otherwise approved by the planning and zoning department. Condition number two, the proposed office complex development will not begin until all plans have been submitted and approved by the planning and zoning department as well as any other required permitting agencies. And condition number three, the approved parking variance is for automation direct only and its own control and under common ownership. Any subsequent sale of this property prior to completion of all the build out will render that parking variance null and void. So there's its own for that parking variance. If you have to answer any questions, and this will require, if you do have any questions, I'll answer those, require that you have a public hearing, and I'll do that for the annexation.
Any questions? Thanks, Scott. I hear a motion to go to public hearing for this annexation request 2013149. Motion to have a second.
Okay.
All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. Anybody like to speak in favor of annexation request 2013149?
Good evening, Mr. Mayor, members of the council. I'm Josh Scoggins, and Bruce Johnson, here on behalf of Proclamation Correct. Mr. Morgan said we're here tonight seeking an annexation of rezoning of 13 and a half acres for all those correct homes on Hutchinson Road that will allow the expansion of its border campus. When this project is complete, the property will have six three-story office buildings, and those buildings will house, among other things, Automation Direct's data center. I know there was a question raised at the last public hearing regarding the road improvements for the 49 Road, the new roof installed traffic signal. The second entrance across from the existing subdivision to help manage traffic in that law project and also the project. We are seeking a minor variance, as Mr. Ward stated, to reduce the parking by 10%. Automation Direct does not need 600 plus spaces to accommodate all of its employees, delivery trucks, and visitors. In closing, I'd just like to say that this is going to be a tremendous economic benefit to the city of Cumming. In addition to 360 permanent jobs, we believe this will generate. It's also going to generate a tremendous number of construction jobs, sales tax dollars, and also utility service dollars. This is a great project being proposed by a model corporate citizen. And this is a great opportunity for the city to continue building on its reputation, fostering and promoting quality business development in our community. Thank you.
Anybody have any questions? I have one question.
Yes, sir.
Josh, what is the time frame on construction of these three buildings?
They plan on beginning development this year.
This year,
yes, sir.
Thank you. Anybody else like to speak in favor of annexation request 2013149? Anybody like to speak in opposition? Annexation request 2013149. Hear motion to close the public hearing? Second. All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much. I think this is the type of growth that we all like. The city and county both has worked on this this type of construction, and it brings in a lot of employees and a lot of tax dollars. So I would recommend the annexation request of 2013149 Automation Direct. They've proved to be a good company for many years here on Hutchinson Road, and we can thank them for better things in the future for them. So, Chair, we entertain a motion.
Make a motion.
Motion, John Daly.
Right.
Second, Quincy. In discussion. All in favor? Signify by raising your right hand. Now we got a variance request.
What, sir, as part of that, you agreed to annex it. We would request that you also make a motion to agree to the rezoning to M1
conditions that based on the planning zoning order, which Scott really did a few minutes ago, I forget about the three word, but one of them was.
One is the parking variance, one is the fact that they will have, they have to have all plans approved before they begin construction, and the others have to adhere to the dimensional requirements. Actually, I think that actually the third issue is about subsequent sale of the property. We need also to mention about the parking variance. Along with that, the parking variance, the parking variance, all the rezoning.
Is it going to vote on the innovation?
You can vote on the rezoning with the three additions and then vote again on the parking variance.
Okay, on the rezoning, I hear a motion that this is. I thought it was in the commercial zone. Obviously, but we got changed.
We got changed to our commercial zone, to our residential zone.
That's what we're looking at, changing the rezoning. I hear a motion. Very motion, we have a second. All in favor, say if I read your right hand. Unanimous. Okay, the variances.
The variances.
As individual, you don't ever get.
We can do all the conditions of parking variance together.
Variances that were requested by the planning department, I hear a motion. Have a second. Any discussion? All in favor, say if I read your right hand. Unanimous. Thanks for that.
Yes.
Thank you very much. Okay, under. Any other business to come forward this board? Under announcements, we have Independence Day festivities. They'll start July the 3rd activities at the fairgrounds at 6 p.m. Be a lot of tailgating, so if you want to see the fireworks at 9:30, you better get there early. It fills up quick. Parade will be up July the 4th, and it starts at 10 o'clock. Also, July the 8th, at 8:30 a.m., there'll be a groundbreaking ceremony at the site of the construction of the new courthouse. So invite everyone to come for that. And on October the 3rd through the 13th, Cumming Country Fair and Festival will start, the annual Country Fair and Festival. On July the 18th, Cumming Playhouse opens for Treasure Island, and that'll go through the August 11th. In closing, let me say thank you to all of our people, residents, and friends in the city and county who has been complimentary in the way we've handled all the rains that we've had. We've had an excessive amount of rains in the last few months, and something unprecedented for this area we've never seen. But we pull up the bootstraps and we keep on and we get it done. We've got a lot of confidence on the way things have been handled. We try to keep ahead of everything, taking care of the debris and the washouts and so forth. So we'll continue to work on that. And with that, with no other business coming for this body, I hear most of the job.
All right, well,
second. All in favor, signify by raising your right hand. Unanimous. Thank you very much.
Yeah.
I'm not.